Hey everyone, my name is Ryan Wold, and I'm a Senior Support Escalation Engineer on the Surface Hub Support Team at Microsoft. With the Windows 10 Team 2020 update, we've added support for Modern Authentication and Exchange Web Services for syncing the device account. I'll navigate to our Administrator Guide so we can look at the documentation of these changes and go over the requirements. Within the guide, on the left, click Surface Hub 2S, then Overview, and open What's New in Windows 10 Team 2020 Update. Towards the top, you'll see a summary line mentioning Modern Authentication for Cloud Device Accounts. To view additional information regarding this, I'll click Modern Authentication on Surface Hub. The main requirement for Modern Auth is the device account needs to authenticate using Azure Active Directory, and the mailbox needs to be hosted in Exchange Online. If your device accounts do not meet these requirements, it will still use legacy authentication. We also now support the EWS protocol and ADAL for syncing the device account. Prior to this update, the Surface Hub used Exchange Active Sync with basic authentication. To use Modern Auth, we need to add the device account in the UPN format, as using the domain/user format is not supported. Now, I'll quickly walk through adding an online device account to the Surface Hub. And later, I'll talk about how to turn off Modern Auth for unsupported environments. To add the device account, I'll first open Settings. Press Start, All Apps, Settings. After authenticating, I'll click Surface Hub. And under Accounts, click Change. After typing the UPN and password, the Surface Hub should auto-discover the Exchange server information and SIP address. As you can see, the EWS server URL is being used, which is new with the 20H2 update. I'll then click Next, and we can see the account has been successfully set up. A really important note, with 20H2, the Surface Hub defaults to using Modern Authentication for device accounts that exist in Azure AD. If the device account does not meet all the previously mentioned requirements for Modern Auth, you may run into an issue where you're unable to add the device account, which may look something like this. If that's the case, you'll need to turn off Modern Authentication on the Surface Hub so it no longer attempts to use it. Disabling Modern Auth is documented on our Known Issues page. I'll minimize Surface Hub 2S on the left, open Surface Hub V1, then Troubleshoot, and then click on Known Issues Windows 10 Team OS. Scroll down and you'll see this row, mentioning Modern Authentication. On the right, we can see a Surface Hub CSP can be used to turn off Modern Auth, as well as a USB provisioning package. The Mdm policy is documented on our Surface Hub CSP page. To locate it, I'll press Ctrl F and type Modern. The policy is device account /exchange modern auth enabled, with the default value of true and a data type of Boolean. To disable modern auth, you'll want to set this value to false and deploy it to your Surface Hubs. Now, I'll go over how to disable modern auth using a package. Heading back to the Known Issues page, I'll select Provisioning Package. This will download the exchange modern auth disabled.ppkg file. I'll then open File Explorer and copy the package file to the root of a USB drive. Then eject it. Insert the USB drive into the Surface Hub. We'll then sign into Settings. Within Settings, go to Surface Hub, Device Management, and then add or remove a provisioning package. Click Add a Package and select Exchange Modern Auth Disabled.ppkg, and then Add. After typing the admin credentials, click Yes, Add it. If you click the Back button, you should now see the package installed. You can now head back to the account settings where you should be able to successfully add the device account. As a reminder, if you want to reconfigure the device account to use modern authentication in the future, you'll need to uninstall this provisioning package. Thanks so much for watching.